Hello my dear friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video I have described UGC NET paper 2 computer science last 10 year questions. In previous video I have described question number 1 to 145. If you want that video, then go to my YouTube channel and find that one. Question number 146. In the case of parallelisms, Amdahl's law states that if P is the proportion of a program that can be made parallel and 1 minus P is the proportion that cannot be parallelized, then the maximum speed up that can be achieved by using N processor is. By using the Amdahl's law, we know that the answer becomes 1 by 1 minus P plus P by N. Next question. Consider an experiment of tossing two fair dice, one black, one red. What is the probability that the number on the black die divides the number on red die? That is, when the number on the black die divides on the number of red die, we can do it as 1 by 1, 2 by 1, 3 by 1, 4 by 1, 5 by 1, 6 by 1, or 2 by 2, 4 by 2, 6 by 2, or 3 by 3, 6 by 3, or 4 by 4, 5 by 5, 6 by 6. That is, total number favorable cases 14 and total number exhaustive cases 36. So, the probability that the number on the black die divides the number on the red die is 14 by 36. I hope you understand. Next questions. How many strings of 5 digit have the property that the sum of the digit is 7? To get this answer, we apply a simple formula, that is C 5 minus 1 plus 7 comma 7. Here C is the combinations, that is we solve it and we get C 11,7 and answer becomes 330. Next question. Consider a unit square centered at origin. The coordinate of the square are translated by a factor 1 by 2 comma 1 and rotated by an angle 90 degree. What will be the coordinates of the new square? Since the length of the square is unit, so we consider it as center becomes 0, 0 and point becomes 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2, there 1 by 2 comma minus 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 and minus half comma by half. This is the rectangles and whose origins are find out, and we know that translation vectors x dash equal to x plus tx, y dash equal to y plus ty, and we get the translations half or 1, we put this value x plus half, x dash equal to x plus half, y dash equal to y plus 1, then apply the rotation formula with theta equal to 90 degree, that is x double dash equal to x dash cos 90 degree minus y dash sin 90 degree, y double dash equal to x dash sin 90 degree plus y dash cos 90 degree, and we put the value, we get answers a minus 3 by 2 comma 1, b minus 3 by 2 comma 0, c minus half comma 0, and d minus half comma 1. When you put this value after translation, we get the new points on the rectangles. Next question. A bell-shaped membership function is specified by three parameters a comma b comma c as follows. The formula becomes 1 by 1 plus x minus c by a whole to the power 2 by b, whole to the power 2b. Next question. There are exactly dash different finite automata with three states x, y and z over the alphabet a, b, where x is always the start state. To get this answer, we use the formula 2 to the power n into n to the power n into m, where n is the number of states and m is the number of input. Here value of n equal to 3 since there are number of states x, y, z, and m equal to 2 since there is 2 alphabet. To show the number of states, we put this value in this equation. We get the answer 2 to the power 3 into 3 to the power 3 into 2. Solve it equal to 8 into 2 to the power 3 to the power 6 equal to 5832. Next question. A device is sending out data at the rate of 2000 bps bit per second. How long does it take to send a file of 1 lakh characters? To solve it, we know that each character is 8 bits, that is 1 lakh character into 8 by 2000 equal to 400. This is the required answer. Next question. A network with bandwidth of 10 Mbps can pass only an average of 15,000 frames per minute, with each frame carrying an average of 8,000 bits. What is the throughput of this network? Since per minute carry 15,000 frames and each frame carry 8,000 bits, so number of bits become 15,000 into 800. And this bit carry in per minute, so we convert into seconds, 60, and again multiply it to 1000 means it convert to kilobits. Again multiply into 1000 means it is convert to megabits. To solve this value, we get 2 Mbps per second. Next question. The three inputs x1, x2, x3 from the 8x3 parity encoder are used to provide a vector address of the form 101 x1 x2 x3 00. What is the second highest priority vector address in hexadecimal if the vector addresses are starting from the one with the highest priority? Since we know that priority, that is, we write it as x1, x2, x3. This is the priority 000, 001, 010, 011. 000 is the first priority, 001, second priority, 010, third priority, 011, fourth highest. So, our answer becomes second highest priority means 001 we take it. So the second highest priority vector address in is in hexadecimal form, we write x1 x2 x3 as 001, so our answer becomes 1010 0100, and if we convert it into hexadecimal form, we get the answer A4 base 16. Next question. A Unix file system has 1 kilobyte, KB capital, that means kilobyte blocks, 4-byte disk addresses. What is the maximum file size if inode contains 10 direct entries, one single, double, and triple indirect entry each? To solve this, direct block entries, one direct block entry contains 1 KB kilobyte. So 10 direct block entries can contains 1 into 10, that is 10 KB. Single indirect block, we have 4-byte addresses, so the number of blocks in indirect block 1 KB by 4 equal to 256 block. So one indirect block entry can point 256 into 1 KB equal to 256 KB. Double indirect block, similarly 256 into 256 into 1 KB equal to 64 MB. Triple indirect block, that is 256 into 256 into 256 into 1 KB, that is 64 MB into 256 equal to 16 GB. So the total size 16 GB plus 64 MB plus 256 KB plus 10 KB equal to 16 GB. For competitive exams, this is a speed matter, so maximum file size is mostly depend on the triple block entries only. For faster approximate answer, we need to calculate triple indirect block, that is, this is the answer 256 256 1 KB equal to 16 GB, that is, this is the required answer. Next question. How many solutions are there for the equation x plus y plus z plus u equal to 29? Subject to the constraint x greater than equal to y greater than equal to 2, and z greater than equal to 3, and u greater than equal to 0. That is, we write it using formula C 4 minus 1 plus 23, 2600. Here, given 29 and x greater than 1, y greater than 2, z greater than 3, we write 1 plus 2 plus 3 equal to 6, that is 29 minus 6 equal to 23. We write it is in formula C 4 minus 1 plus 23, 23 equal to 2600. To get more answers, kindly subscribe this video. Thank you for today.